the recreational leisure, human rights, all these are included in the level of the different skills which have these components, and we tend to identify the level of living of an individual, and we can grade that this is good, this is moderate, this is poor. So we tend to incorporate these components, and we tend to grade the individual based on these basic nine components. The most important subjective component, or the most important component of this class, that is the quality. Major to be estimated because of individual perceptions of the things. So the condition of life, this number of factors, and the factors included here are determining your health, the factor which determine your health, educated you are, the factors creating your social and the intellectual attainments, the role you play in the society, how intellectual you are, the freedom of action, justice, and the freedom of expression. So as per WHO, this quality of life is more or less a condition of life. It is we do not have a scale like the objective component, but it is a subjective component, and it is a condition of the individual solely based on the number of factors like those we determine our health, happiness. Happiness, again, it includes the comfort in the physical environment, the physical parameter, whether are good enough or not, we are in comfort zone or not, and also includes the satisfying occupation. So the work, apart from the physical environment, the workplace or the other and another environment we tend to have, we tend to be in the that for major part of our day-to-day activities. So also it is included in this quality of life, the education, social, intellectual attainment, freedom, again the number of factors. A composite, it is a composite measure of these physical, mental, and social well-being as perceived by individual. So the most important is that it is perceived by the individual. Again, because of the perception of the individual or the inter-individual variation of the perceptions, it becomes a difficult task to identify or measure this quality of life. So the rise in the standard of living is not enough. Now we have a new concept that if we improve the standard of living, would it be enough for the individual? No, because the ultimately what is perceived by an individual is his or her quality of life. So improvement in the quality of life must be added to the conditions which tend to improve the standard of living. So nowadays, what is being done? The increased emphasis is given on the social policy and on the reformulation of the societal goals to make life more livable for all those who will survive. So barely increasing the standard of living and the level of living would not do for the individual. So this increased emphasis is nowadays on the this social policy and the reformulation of these societal goals to make life more livable, and how we can do, we can only do by improving the quality of the individual who are living in a society. Now how to measure this quality of life? We have two very important components for measuring this. Two or skills for measuring this quality of life. First is the PQLI, एक PQLI इज सिंपली द फिजिकल क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ इंडेक्स, द अदर वन इज द HDI और द ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स. यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज दिस PQLI, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस PQLI, एंड सिमिलरली फॉर द HDI, हाउ वी टेंड टू कैलकुलेट द HDI, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स एंड वेयर वी स्टैंड इन दीज इंडेसेस. So we start with the first component of the subjective quality of life parameter, that is the physical quality of life index. There are three basic components or the basic parameters which are incorporated in this PQLI. The first and foremost is the infant mortality. Infant, you understand that all the children who are less than 1 year of age are known as infant, and it tend to incorporate the mortality rate of these individual or the children who are less than 1 year of age. Then the second component is the life expectancy at age 1. So what is the expectancy of the life of the individual at the age of 1 year? Then the third component is the literacy rate. So these are the three basic measures which are incorporated for calculating this physical quality of life index. So what is missing in this physical quality of life index? Any one of you can just type in your chat box that a component which you feel which is being missed in this physical quality of life index, or which is not incorporated in this PQLI. We have a status of the health of the under ones. We have a life expectancy. We have a literacy rate. What which in parameter we do not have in this? Zainab has typed that money again. Yes, very important that money has not been incorporated in this PQLI. So there is a reason why money is not incorporated. It is so that it has been seen that solely the economic growth does not. Education, literacy is included. That means education is included. So the money or the monetary. No need to sorry. So money is not included because it is seen that simply getting rich or getting the amount of good enough money does not include the quality of life. I will give an example with regard to this regarding the monetary issues. First, let us finish with this PQLI. So these are the different components, and these are incorporated to an index which is between a lowest value is zero and it has increased highest or the maximum dimension of this index is 100. So a lowest would be a worst scene, and the 100 would be a ideal or the best scene. So coming to the issue of money, money is not everything. Again, it is seen, I have told that it is seen that like an example, I give an example of the countries which have a high GNP, like the Middle East countries. It is the example is also recorded in your textbook of Community Medicine of Park, that these countries or the Middle East countries tend to have a high GNP. That means that the individuals residing there have a high purchasing power. But on the other hand, these individuals do not tend to match the as per the GNP. They do not tend to match the PQLI indices of the other developed countries. It is so because simply getting rich or getting enough money does not include your quality of life, because there are different components. So they are tend to be on the lower side in the PQLI index as compared to the GNP index, where they are number of individuals having enough money are more. Contrary to this, take an example of Sri Lanka, where the purchasing power of the individual is not as high as compared to the Middle East countries, or the GNP or the GDP is on a lower side, but they tend to excel in the PQLI index. Again, it shows that simply getting enough money does not improve our quality of life. And the other important thing that this PQLI does not measure the economic growth of society and individuals as such. more vulnerabilization of you to it changes our social, economic and the political policies. Not specifically the economic is related with the overall the concept of health or the state subject of the health. It is not on the individual basis. So this is about the PQLI. So in PQLI we have infant mortality, we have a life expectancy at age one, and we have a literacy. Now coming to the another component, that is an HDI or the Human Development Index. The other very important component or the measure to assess the quality of life. This Human Development Index, it is a statistical tool which is used to measure a country's overall achievement in its social and the economic dimensions. It allows for the international comparison because we have a such a index where the inter-country variation can be compared at times. It is developed by the United Nations Development Program in way back in 1990. Unlike PQLI, the HDI ranges from 0 to 1. The PQLI was ranged between 0 and 100. So it tend to have a fraction of the values, that it can have any value between 0 and the maximum or the highest or the ideal condition would ideal countries would have a value of 1. So what are the components of this HDI? There are basic three dimensions which are being defined in this for calculating this Human Development Index, and these dimensions are decent standard of living. These are the basic dimensions, right? The standard of living is one of the dimension. The other dimension here is the knowledge, and the third dimension is the long and healthy life. So long and healthy life, the longevity of individual or the residence of the individual, and how healthy they are. So these are the basic three dimensions. If we have a dimension, we need to have a indicator for each of them. So talking about the first dimension or the decent standard of living, how this is a dimension, how we tend to measure. So the indicator here is the GNI per capita. GNI is the again gross national income of an individual. Per capita is the per income of the individual, and it is being calculated in dollars. PPP here is the purchasing power parity of individual. So this is the indicator. GNI per capita is the index of this standard of living. I think someone has unmuted. So it is echoing here. Please mute yourself. I think there is a disturbance. Please, students, mute yourself. So the second dimension is the knowledge. How we would be assessing the knowledge for Human Development Index? Again, we need to have an indicator. An indicator used here is the, there are two indicators. The first is the mean years of schooling, and second is the expected years of schooling. And this indicator would lead to a education index for this. So the first dimension was standard of living. For that indicator, for indicator of dimension of standard of living, we had a GNI per capita. The other dimension was knowledge, and would be indicated by mean years of schooling and the expected years of schooling. The third dimension is the long and healthy life. For the long and healthy life, the indicator or the basic measure what we have here is the life expectancy at the birth. In PQLI, remembered, we had a life expectancy at the age of one. But in HDI, we have a life expectancy at birth. So this life expectancy of birth would lead to a life expectancy index. So ultimately, what would be having? Would be having a GNI index for the standard of living, would be having a education index for the knowledge, and would be having a life expectancy index for the long and healthy life. So basically, would be having three indices, and we would be compiling them, and ultimately what we would get, we would get a human development index. It is taking a bit more time. Yes. So the three indicators, the life expectancy at birth, mean years of schooling, and the expected years of schooling from the knowledge and the income. These indicators we have already talked about. How we will be calculating this HDI index? For every three measures, we would be calculating, like in the numerator, we have a difference between the actual value and a minimum value. So these actual and the minimum value, there is a different concept how we take the actual value. Actual value are the present value of the country, and the maximum value here is the highest value from calculated over the three decades, starting from 1980 to 2011. So the highest value of the region and any country may have highest value, that is incorporated in the index. We would be doing exercises in your demonstration classes regarding this, how we need to calculate this. So in the numerator, we have a difference between the actual and the minimum value, while in the denominator, we have a difference between the maximum and the minimum value. So this is the graph showing the present HDI index of 2000, that the report is published in 2020, and the index is of 2019. So in the rank one, you can see here the country of Norway. What is the HDI value of Norway here? It is 0.957. So the maximum value which can be attained is 1. So it is very near to attaining the ideal condition. So Norway is followed by Ireland, that is ranked second, and the HDI value is 0.955. And as we scroll down, we would be getting our country of India. And anyone can guess, so where we stand in this HDI ranking? Where India stands in this HDI ranking? What is the value of HDI of India? The last noted.
136.
131. 131. So 131 is the right answer. This is 2009. That needs to that can be changed every year, because the certain parameters we may improve, and on the certain parameters we may lose also. So in HDI value of India in 2019 was, the rank was 131, and the parameter, the measure was 0.645. But what we need to understand, that we have improved a lot in these parameters which are incorporated in this HDI index. We have improved many folds in this life expectancy at birth. We have improved on the years of schooling, and we have also improved on the this GNI and the mean years of schooling. But still, we are have a uphill task of improving in this HDI index. So you need to understand that is still a huge challenge for us to improve the quality of life of the individual, improve the quality of life of our countrymen. This is about this was one parameters or quality of life. Then we come to the third objective of this class, that is the system of health. So we have learned about the definition of health. We have learned about the concept of well-being. So in the health again, we say that health is not a static concept. It is a dynamic concept where the individual tend to at times may become ill, individual may poop, individual may become cure of disease, and the individual develops the positive health. While at times individual, as individual develops it, individual becomes ill, individual sickness may improve, he may develop, deteriorate, his condition may deteriorate, and ultimately the individual may die because of the disease condition. So, the spectrum and a slight life, we need to understand that the spectrum of health lies between this positive health. As we move down, it can go to the bottom of the bottom of this slide, the depth. So, the spectrum may vary at times between the positive health to the depth. So, the first outcome we may have is the death of the individual because of an illness. Less severe sickness, it is, we can say that that is the worst phenomenon of death. Then as we move up, the sickness will decrease. We have a mild illness, and then as we move above the mild sickness, we have unrecognized sickness. And as we move above from this, we move from down to the increasing dimensions of health, like the freedom from, we become free from the sickness, we go on health, and ultimately we become ultimately what we attain is the positive health. So this is about the spectrum of health. So what we need to understand is that health is not that a state, we need to measure of individual. So I am healthy today, I may become ill tomorrow, I may become disease tomorrow. So my parameters, if the parameters may improve one day, they may deteriorate one day. So there is a specific dimension for this whole spectrum where the individual may lie. So, what we have discussed today, briefly revise that whether we have achieved our objective or the goals. Like we start with the outline by well-being, though we do not have an ideal definition, but at least we have at least understood that that is the concept or it is the condition of the individual, which are based on the different components. It is included how educated an individual is, the amount of money he has, the working environment, the physical parameters of the individuals, or the services which are available to him. All these are included in his the concept of well-being. And for the well-being, we have two basic components: the objective one and the subjective one. Under the objective component, we have two criteria like the standard of living and the level of living. And the subjective component, we have our quality of life, and already told that the quality of life depends of the individual, but it depends on the perception of the individuals, how our body is, and how it includes the individual, how satisfied he is with his profile, how satisfied he is with his role in society as such. And how he takes the gratification in his life. So the different components are there in this subjective quality of life component. And for this, we have our physical quality of life index and then the human development index. In the physical quality of, just to remind that in the physical quality of life, we have three basic parameters like the infant mortality, the life expectancy of one, and the literacy rate of a country. While in the HDI, we have three we tend to cover the three dimensions, and it includes the standard of living, the knowledge, and the long and healthy life. PQI is ranged from 0 to 10, 0 to 100, but HDI is ranged from 0 to 1. And lastly, we discussed about the spectrum of health. So, just conclude that what we are today, we may not be tomorrow. How healthy we are today, we may have a disease tomorrow. We may not be having a perfect health tomorrow, and we tend to have a severe illness and may die at one day. So this is a clear spectrum of health, and it is a dynamic thing. So this was just a brief introduction to this concept of well-being to you. And if you have a query, we may take up the now. If anybody want to ask something or want to discuss or give any input, because I think it is difficult for you to attend this online classes. Have been through this foundation course and we have also started this online class. If anyone want to give an input, he or she is welcome. You may give your number in the chat box as well. You may type your comments. We have time left. Anyone? Sorry, I can't hear you. Sorry,
books kis asar karta hai community medicine.
Basically, we start with textbooks of community medicine by Park. That is at least the basic book which is being taken up by the students. Apart from this, we have books from other authors as well. And I would be suggesting you to read this. We have a book by the writers from AFMC. We have different books for the health program as well. We would be communicating to you when you when we start with this physical classes. We will be suggesting what to read, what is important for you. So what we need to understand in this subject of community medicine, you would be it is being started in the first year, and you will be reading your subject till your mid prof part 1. So the first book which is taken is the part, but there are a number of books would be communicating to you as we would be meeting the physical class.
Thanks.
Anyone else? You can also give input like how we can improve this online class, how we can make this more interesting. You can give your valuable suggestions. No more suggestions? Okay, should we close the class? So I think you people become happy when I said that should we close the class. So I end here. We would be taking about the determinants of health in the next class, and keep enjoying yourself and take some time to review what we have discuss. So you may log out. I would be ending this class. Thank you very much. Thank you.